Hello, me again. Okay, so in this video, you're gonna see how I actually did this little crooked. It's crooked, isn't it? You're gonna see how I did this cute little DIY. I'm obsessed with it because like it's literally multi-purpose. I can stick it to anything now, and I'm so happy. It's so much more sturdy, and I just feel like having it be Velcro, it just kind of adds to the feel of the, you know, the ensemble. So if you wanna see how I did it and see my sewing machine in action, keep watching.
So this is what we're looking like with just the glue. And like, it's a little durable. I can open it, close it, like, you know, but the edges come up. So it's like one wrong move. Oh, it's pretty strong actually. Actually, I really could rock with this, but it's just not enough. For me, like, I'm very rough with things. Like, I move around a lot. I'm actually surprised it didn't just fall off just What I wanted to do with this was kind of see. It covers it for the most part. So I'm gonna take my seam rippers, detach the Velcro from the actual band. So yeah, I don't know if you remember me mentioning these in wig videos, but I get these from the dollar store. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take my seam ripper, take the Velcro off both sides, trace this into a triangle, maybe a little bit bigger or smaller. I don't know. I'm trying to decide. Okay, so the bottom should be the soft side. We'll see how this goes, and then I can just glue this to the back. We'll see how it works. It's gonna be like three-dimensional, I think, but maybe not. If all else fails, we'll just do the glue. But bruh, I gotta start practicing more, cause like, I don't want this to go to waste. Now that I'm not an actor, especially if the singing don't work out, I gotta make clothes, bitch. These are going to be my best friend for changing out screws and needles. Look at this cute little screwdriver. Okay, so what are we doing first? Taking this. This little secret compartment is where we keep things like seam ripper, seam snipper. Also very handy on nights out. You can either stretch to see where it's stitched. Just about a couple. And then go to the other side and look at the damage and kind of just follow that. Pull, rip. And it gets easier because the random little ones that you open start to, you know, follow suit. Okay, so we separated one. I'm gonna do the other one and remove all these extra little threads and then come back. Okay, so I've got my top and bottom Velcro pieces, and now I'm going to trace them. This is the fuzzy side. I'm gonna flip it over, place it like that. So yeah, I keep my chalk in this little bag thing. Let me see if it'll work. There's like no edge sharp enough. No, I guess something that looks like that. I like that it's a little bit sticky there because it's gonna help hold this in place while I sew it down. So now I'm gonna do this to this and, you know, move on to this. I'm gonna put it backwards just to make sure it lines up. Okay, so I got my Velcro pieces ready to go. So I've trimmed my Velcro down to where I think it's usable. Lucky for me, there's a bit of whatever material was left from the original bag left, so I'm going to utilize that to crazy glue the Velcro to, and then I'm gonna sew on the other Velcro patch, and hopefully it's more sturdy. By the way, I lost a gem, but like, it's not a big deal. I'm gonna put it back on, whatever. Maybe not, maybe never. I wanna clean this up as much as humanly possible, just because I'm not doing this a third time. Okay, this should be like a one-time stick thing, so I'm gonna be somewhat generous with this glue. I really wish I had fabric glue, or at least E5000, but deadass, everything is closed. Okay, I'm gonna use tweezers because if this gets on me, I'm toast. I'm gonna allow it to dry because I'm not trying to play no games, play no games. I'm gonna add more glue in certain areas. So it's on now. And the thing about this that makes it sick is pretty much anywhere there's Velcro, I can stick this. So yeah, while this dries, I'm gonna try to rethread this. I'll be back in a bit. There's Velcro on this side that I might have to sew through, but I don't care because I'm not undoing all of these seams to redo that. When I pull this down, it's to go back. I'm scared. I'm so scared. Put the needle down. Pivot. Man, I did this all wrong. Okay, whatever. I backstitched so I can take it off. and just start a new line. So you can see a wee bit of the white, but honestly, no one will see that. And that's what the back looks like so far. You can see where I backstitched there and there. Maybe it will be easier with this. It's a lot of gravity I'm fighting right now. Okay, I think the tension is too tight or something, because you can see the white on this side, but it should be fine. Can you see all the places I backstitched? Beautiful. All right, so I'm gonna take these, flip off. Now, I'm very extra, but I also know how durable I need things to be, so just in case, I'm gonna put a couple drops of crazy glue just over. All right, so this DIY is pretty much done. So it's pretty much finished, but what I'm not really liking, why are my hands always so ashy? What I'm not liking is that you can see, like if you do look hard enough, you can see the stitching. So this is my solution. And I'm literally just gonna take this marker and color over. If I had a Sharpie, this would be actually ideal. I'm just gonna color all of these threads black and then you'll see the difference. These ones especially. Little circular motions over each knot really quickly and boom, it's fully black. You can't see anything now. You can still kind of see the crazy glue, but this is the progress so far. You see how the stitches just disappear with the black over it? So yeah, I'm just gonna finish this and that's pretty much the end of it. Like, it's good to go. Take this off to wash it. So there we have it. It's not, you know, like perfect obviously, but when I open it, no one will really be able to tell right away. So I wish the thrift stores were open. You can find logos and emblems on all kinds of janky little bags in all kinds of places. Just ditch the bag and, you know, do the DIY. I'm so happy with how this turned out.
All right, that was the video. I want to do more stuff like this, but there's like nowhere to thrift. Like, I just want to go to thrift stores and find little pendants and all that kind of shit so I can DIY Velcro attachments and things, but it's fine. I love how I said I'd wear more clips and I'm not wearing any clips today. I think it'd be kind of overkill. Plus, I'm about to go out anyway, so who really cares? But yeah, I really hope you enjoyed this video. Like, comment, subscribe. Especially comment, because I want to know your thoughts. What else? Anything else? That's pretty much it. I'm gonna see y'all in the next